Hello everybody! I am back with another Twitch stream, and today we are going to be playing Life is Strange True Colors! Yeah! It is the last game in the series. And so let's just get started. This also includes some characters from the from before the storm, like Steph. I don't know if it has Mikey in it though. I forgot, but I know it has Steph. And I think it also shows, it also mentions Chloe in it, which I really like. And there's a backstory on Steph, or where there's a side story for Steph. Let's just get into it. New game. This, I already played this game. But like, I think when it first came out in like 2019, no, 2020, I forgot, but it didn't come out too long ago, so.
So, Alex, the day's finally here.
Okay.
You've been at the Helping Hands group home for 8 years. We've been through a lot in that time.
We have.
And now you're finally leaving to live with your brother.
My brother, Gabe.
It says here he lives in Haven Springs, Colorado. Is that correct?
Oh, Haven Point? Oh.
That's a big move. Do you have any plans as far as school or a job?
My brother said I might pick up a few shifts at the bar he works at.
So you'd be dealing with people?
Maybe.
I forgot what happened.
Does your brother know about your issues?
Like her power?
Is that an official interview question, Dr. Lin?
Alex, you know that I care about you. With everything that has happened, I just want what's best for you.
He doesn't know. No one will once I leave this place. I'll just be a normal girl in a normal town.
Yo, Life is Strange, True Colors. This isn't my favorite out of the entire series, but I still like it. It's pretty good, but it gets a lot of hate.
Gabe said to meet him at the bridge. I can't wait to see him.
This bridge? Where's Gabe? Where's Gabe at? Where's our brother? Okay.
Alex.
Yo, that's
Holy
Gabe.
Holy shit.
Her brother.
That's really him.
Oh, what's the protocol for reuniting with your long-lost sister after 8 years?
Let's hug.
I'm cool with the hug if you are.
Yeah!
Oh, is crushing my ribs still part of the protocol?
It's just so good to see you again. I can't believe you're here.
Believe it.
She's all grown up. And I missed it.
I'm a lot taller, huh?
Yeah. Time will do that to you.
What does purple mean?
Are you ready to see the town?
Let's do it.
Hell yeah, let's rock and roll. I don't know why I said that.
Me neither. But I love the enthusiasm. Okay, the Black Lantern is just up the street. I mentioned I live above a bar, right?
Even better.
How was the trip? You must be wiped.
I'm good. The drive through the mountains was amazing.
Eleanor, hey, Alex just got here. Alex, meet Eleanor Leith, owner of the flower shop, and honest to God, royalty of Haven Springs.
Oh, it is so nice to finally meet you. Welcome. Oh. We are so glad to have you, Alex. Gabe told us all about you.
I'm glad to be here. She seems nice.
Yeah, she's great. A little quick on the draw with hugs, though.
Yeah, no shit.
Welcome to Haven.
This just sounds so awkward with no music. Yeah.
It's nice.
Come on.
I know there's this one part. It's
is
so funny.
Is this the first official stop on the tour?
Because they're
absolutely
dancing to music,
if
but there's no
inside,
music.
You'll find a prize exhibit. Gabe Chen buys makeup flowers for angry girlfriend.
Oh, I can't wait.
It's gotten so reviews.
Hey, Gabe.
Riley, meet my sister, Alex.
What's your greatest weakness? What?
It's for a college interview. We've been debating this one for days.
Gabe insists that I give an honest answer.
It's always better to give an honest answer.
And what's the alternative? Lying?
Not lying, more like strategic half-truthing. Like, I work too hard, or I save too many puppies.
They could smell that bullshit a mile away. I've been trying to warn her.
Oh, yeah? What would you do?
I'll be honest.
I would be honest. It's usually harder, but then you come off as more authentic.
Called it!
Wow. You two are already wonder-twinning your way through town.
Seems that way.
Alex, help me out real quick. What do I get for Charlotte? Sunflowers are her favorite, but I read online that Lily of the Valley is great for saying sorry. What do you think?
I'll get Lily of the Valley.
Go with the white bouquet.
OMG, does everything have an effect on what I do?
That I am.
I mean, that's
and
literally
that
the whole point of the game, but still.
You know, if Mac brought me flowers half as often,
well, he wouldn't be Mac.
Is it still on and off with you two?
Sort of. More on right now, but wait 5 minutes and ask again.
Put this on my tab?
Yeah.
Are you sure you don't want to just tell Mac about the interview?
No, not yet. I'll handle it.
Okay, your call. We can leave when you're ready.
Sounds good.
Okay. I want to look around a bit.
Might as well have a look around before we leave. How to Kill Everything You Touch, a flower book by Alex Chen. Mandatory for any enchanted garden.
Oh, no category for estranged brother you haven't seen in 8 years because you were ripped apart by the foster care system?
Yeah.
Perfect.
That guy's bad to the no.
OMG, mind your business.
I heard he was
broken around.
Oh God, please stop. No problem.
Let's go back here. Okay, never mind, I can't go back there. Let's hold. Oh, okay.
What if I don't get in? Shit. What if I do get in? Am I really ready to leave this place?
If Riley's so anxious about leaving this town, I guess it can't be too bad.
Get ready to go. Let's go.
Ready.
Thanks. See you soon, Rai.
Oh my God, is this like Haven Point, like in the second one?
How long have you and Charlotte been dating?
Look.
About 3 years now.
They have the same name. It can't be a coincidence.
You must spend a lot of money on bouquets.
She's worth it.
MG, when are we gonna see Steph? Is that the dispensary or what?
Well, here we are.
Can I go in?
I bet Gabe keeps the flower shop in business all by himself.
Step one, patch things up with Charlotte. And step two, Alex and Charlotte become best friends and everyone's happy forever.
Gabe's pretty nervous about making sure I'll like it here. It's sweet. Gabe Chen, flower delivery man.
I know, right? Let me duck in here and smooth everything out. It'll only be a minute. I'll introduce you properly later. Once, you know.
It's no problem, really.
It's gonna be longer than a minute.
Oh.
Trust me.
Little less kid.
Oh. Hi there.
Gabe's your brother, right? I'm Ethan. Charlotte's my mom.
Hi, Ethan. I'm Alex. What you reading?
Ninth Warden.
Oh, has she found the Scepter of Serenity yet?
She's looking for the Scepter, but I think she'll need the Bangle of Vanishing to get to it.
Vanishing my kind of power. I prefer the fire ring.
I'd rather shoot fire from my hand. Burn all my enemies to a crisp.
What if you're high-fiving a friend and the fire ring goes off? Risky. If you like comics, I can...
Aww.
Show you the one I'm making.
Yeah.
I'd love to see it.
You can keep it if you want. I made a bunch of copies to sell in the record store.
This is awesome, Ethan. I can't wait to read it. Are you going camping?
You know the mines?
I know they exist.
There are a bunch of old tunnels all around the mountains. I think I found a way into one.
I mean, I'm not an expert on old mines, but that would scare the crap out of me.
I just like to explore sometimes. It's no big deal. Oh, man. I shouldn't have told you that.
Mm-hmm. Promise you'll be careful?
I know we just met, but be careful out there, okay?
You don't need to worry. Really.
That is not gonna end good. Because I know what happens.
I think I'll check out that record store.
This little ass kid does not need to be going over there by himself. He's a little less kid. Oh my god, are we gonna see Steph? I love seeing old characters from like past games. Like how we saw David in the second one, and now we're seeing Steph in this one.
Oh, wow.
I forgot his name, but there's that country-ass motherfucker.
This place reminds me of the shop Gabe and I used to go to. He'd save up for weeks from his shitty car wash job just to buy us something to listen to. It's crazy. Here I am, years later, still waiting for my big brother in the record store. Except this time, I'm buying the record. No way.
Oh my god, Steph! Unicorn parade. Zombie parade.
Citizens of Haven Springs, that was the Wednesday with Bomb Squad. Up next, a very special request from some chick.
She's still wearing the same beanie after years. How long has it been since the first game? Like, in-game
Sorry,
time.
Sorry, the store's actually closed right now. Which is confusing because it's obviously open. Wait. Are you Alex?
That's me.
Wow. Gabe's been talking about you coming since... forever. I'm Ryan.
Hi, Ryan. Nice to meet you.
So, all the way from Portland, huh? What do you think of Haven?
Cool so far.
I've seen some cool things so far. Like, this record store is amazing. I didn't expect anything like this here.
Yep. It's our cultural landmark for sure.
So, the store is closed, but they opened it just for you? You must be picking up something pretty important.
Yeah, well, you could say that.
An outdoorsman's guide to the calls of common birds. Wow, that's... not what I was expecting at all.
It's a pretty obscure record. The National Park Service gave it 5 stars.
So, you're a...
Colorado State Park Ranger.
It's all coming into focus. Well, bummer the store's closed. I was thinking of getting a gift for Gabe, but I'll figure something else out. I don't even know if he still listens to records.
He does. Charlotte just got him a record player for his birthday. I'm pretty sure he put something on hold.
So you don't work here?
Steph won't mind. It'll be the easiest sale she's ever made. If I could just find the whole list. Damn. No, I saw it before. Want to help me look?
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Look.
Any ideas on where to start?
Oh, I think I remember where it's at.
No idea.
I know.
Stuffy
I know.
All over the place.
Right here.
Wait.
World's okay as boyfriend. God, you were right. Really feel like I'll get used to saying that with you. I won't get used to hearing it. By the way, I invited you to our neighborhood on my block. Check it out when you have a sec. Cool, thanks. Alex, who's this? Holy shit, Alex Chen. Sorry, who is this? It's Gabe. Is this some kind of joke? No, you're gonna call me right now. Hey, so Red catching up. You started to chat again later? Yeah, sure. Hey, I was working pretty good.
Is that the hold list?
Oh shit. Wait, what am I doing right now? I thought I could. No, that bitch is gonna attack me.
Just gonna. Okay, just kidding.
I'm surprised you got out of there with both your hands.
Thing is, she's sitting on the hold list.
We could use her toy to lure her away. If we can find it. Give me a hand.
It's scared. She's probably not gonna listen anyways. Oh!
Shit.
Okay, yeah, that didn't work out either. So let's go find her toy. Let's see.
Chores are an excellent way to learn personal responsibility, Alex.
Where is her toy? Can this bitch get the fuck out of the way? Can I not? Let's go. Girl, where the hell is this toy? How do I look at my tasks? Is Mikey in this game? I don't think so, but I think he's mentioned. Okay, let's help, I guess.
Any luck finding that cat toy?
Not yet. So, what's the prediction? What do you think Gabe listens to these days?
I'm guessing he's gotten pretty deep into the acoustic EDM scene.
Isn't that an oxymoron?
Wait, I don't know.
Isn't all great music?
Whoa. Deep. Well, there's only one way to find out. Let's see if we can find that cat toy.
Or wait.
Maybe that drawer?
It could be Celine Dion's greatest hits.
You mean the essential Celine Dion?
She is a Canadian treasure. Nothing.
In there?
Maybe in the junk box.
And we have a winner.
Yes! We found it. Now let's get to that little bitch so we can open the ship. Or
be
so we can get the list.
If I die a horrible cat-related death, tell Gabe I'm sorry. Who's the superior mammal now? All right. Good idea.
Thanks. For a guy who lives in the woods, I'm pretty good at this customer service thing.
The Kings of Leon, tiny blue bot. Okay.
Should have known. I can see why Gabe fits in so well here.
Okay. Ah, I keep clicking tab. It's always been tab. Now it's escape.
Wait. Seriously?
Gabe and I used to listen to records together all the time. We'd forget about the world and rock out for hours.
You gotta tell me what Gabe was like as a kid. Any ammunition you can give me?
He was a dork.
He acted cool, but he was really a big dork. Like, one time he was pretending to stage dive and fell off the bed. Yeah. Sprained an ankle.
Dumb boy.
You know, you being here is a game changer in the Gabe embarrassing department. All right, you're looking at 20 even.
No, no way. Oh. I can't believe you're doing this again.
Come on.
Do you have any idea how much time I've put into this? You just... No, dude, I can't come over there. I'm working.
I guess when people get mad,
maybe you'd understand if you ever
her emotions start to go everywhere.
You gotta get out of here.
Hey, hold on a sec. Are you serious?
You have a playlist, right? I think I can handle that.
You're a lifesaver. Oh, no bird calls though. I'll be there. One sec. Organizing a LARP shouldn't be this hard.
Are you okay?
Never better.
I'm great, thanks. Just, did she say organizing a LARP?
Yep. Beyond DJing, Steph's also queen of the Haven nerds.
Sounds like there's some unrest in the kingdom.
Somehow I knew I'd find you in here.
Things went well with Charlotte?
Thanks to your help. I can't wait for you guys to meet. I think you'd be great friends. Speaking of, my two favorite people in my favorite place. What have you guys been up to?
Talking about birds.
You know, talking about bird calls and bird call related media. This guy really loves his birds.
Guilty.
You know we're trying to keep her in Haven, right? Anyway, I'm glad you two met. Not only is this dude my best friend, he's the best guide to Haven you could ever find.
And this dude hands me the best beers? Hey, by the way, Mac was in here earlier, and...
Hey, Alex, it's Steph. Sorry I had to run now like a crazy person. Excited to meet you for real at the Lantern Tonight YouTube. How did she get my number? Oh, my shit's right here. My to-do list. Okay. Oh, who are these people? Oh, is this her her song thing? Tessa, anger, bitter and jealous and a little queasy. That's what the anger tasted like. Didn't even have time to step back. Seconds later, I was rushing across the room. What a mess. I split her lip open. Poor thing. I wonder how long it will take to heal. It's hard to clean blood off of your clothes. Makes you feel wrong. I don't really blame her for being upset. She thinks I get special treatment at the home, but I don't. Doesn't matter now. She keeps to herself. Most of the other kids do, actually. So that'll be business as usual until a new group comes in and this starts all over again. The worst part, they confiscated my fucking guitar. 2-week ban. At least I get it back. I promise. It's not what you say. No favors or secrets. None coming my way. And after all this, you still had to pay. Isabella, anguish. I tried to write this so many times, and they all ended up in the trash. Let's see how far I can get. I really liked Isabella. She was sweet and loved to paint, and smuggled in a few beers for us on the weekends. But her depression was brutal. It crept under my fingernails and made my eyelids feel like stone, and I had to focus just to keep breathing, like dipping your ribcage in lead. It was hard to get away from. Eventually, it got too much. 2 bottles of sedatives, lying in vomit. Her eyes open and glassy and afraid. I'm sorry, Isabel. I thought we could have stayed friends when we finally got out of this vanilla-flavored holding pen. I wish you could have stuck around for a little longer. If I ever see you again, I'll bring the beer. Did your friend kill herself? All right.
He really wants to talk to you.
He knows where to find me. Anyway, my shift starts in 20. Ready to go? Tag along?
I'll catch up. I got a radio show to host.
I should check in. Do you mind?
No, yeah, of course.
What up, Monster Slayer Thanor?
Hey.
1 week to the launch.
Oh, is that the game?
Hell yeah.
Attaboy.
Stefan Mackey, we're playing.
Next. It's a long drive to Denver.
Are we driving with Steph?
We'll see. She's a GM, so she's got to be in Denver pretty early. What are you doing tonight?
Mom says I'm supposed to stay at the Lantern until she gets off work. But I kind of want to hang out at home. Is that okay?
Do you, man. But I'm going to check that homework later tonight, though. Better be done, capiche?
Capiche. Good to meet you.
Yeah, same. See you around. So weird seeing you do the dad thing.
Dad thing? No. No, I'm better than a dad. I'm like dad plus. We trust each other. He tells me stuff he doesn't even tell Char.
Ethan didn't tell Gabe about going to explore the old mine. He trusted me to keep his secret. Should I? Or should I blow his cover?
I know what happens. So I feel like it's gonna happen regardless. Like, what? I can't say what happens because it's spoilers. But what happens is a canon event. But at the same time, like, I have to tell Gabe because, like, that's a little less kid. What's he gonna be doing out of mine? But if I keep Ethan secret, it's a, like, it's a canon event, so, and I feel like I'm gonna tell Gabe. Let's tell Gabe. Because that's a little less kid, we have to go. I'm gonna have to tell Gabe.
Okay. I should probably tell you something.
Shoot.
Earlier when Ethan and I were talking, he mentioned exploring some old mine.
Oh, man.
He seemed like he knew what he was doing, but I thought you'd want to know.
This fucking kid. I'm gonna tell Charlotte. Just give me a sec. Ooh, Ethan's in trouble.
Really?
We'll see. I appreciate you telling me. You did the right thing. What do you say we get you settled in?
So, this is what a mining town looks like. Thought there'd be more guys in overalls running around.
With soot all over their faces?
Exactly. What do they mine here, though?
Used to be silver back in the day.
And now?
Uranium. They blow these big holes in the mountains and sell it off to nuclear power plants.
Oh.
Yeah. We'll actually be able to hear a blast later tonight. It's pretty intense.
Sounds like it.
Look who it is. Jed. Hey, got someone I want you to meet. Alex, this is my buddy Jed.
Buddy hell, will you listen to this horse shit? His boss, he means.
You own the Black Lantern.
for the last 12 years or so. It's good to meet you, Alex. Heard a hell of a lot about you.
Oh?
Only bad stuff. Mostly lies.
Your brother's full of shit, you know that? He just about wet himself waiting for you to get here.
Same.
I was excited to see him too. Guess we're an almost wet yourself kind of family.
Ha! I like her.
Yeah, she's okay, I guess. We're heading in. You coming?
In a minute. Supposed to meet Eleanor to talk Spring Festival decorations. He tell you about the festival yet?
No.
Not in detail.
I'll fill you in later. Like, you do not want to get this guy started.
I'm loquacious, goddammit. It's charming. Oh, before you leave, word of warning. Max got that old bug up his ass again.
So I've heard.
Yeah. So, just, you know, eyes open. Anyway, you guys go settle. Alex, pleasure.
All mine, Jed. So, Spring Festival equals Mountain Prom.
It's a lot cooler than it sounds.
Not possible. I'm picturing some straight-up Wicker Man shit.
Oh, you've been before.
I'm gonna try not to cheat in this game. Because I always be looking up, like, the consequences. Because, like, I don't want to fuck anything up. But I'm going to try not to look anything up in this game. Because I know there's this part where I had to get, like, everybody to believe me about something. I forgot. But...
shit, man.
I'm going to try not to cheat.
This is all yours?
Don't sound so surprised.
Really nice.
When you said that you had a nice place, I was picturing small but homey.
Well then, welcome to my crib.
Yep.
Seriously, this is great.
And the best part is, it's actually yours.
What?
I'm mostly staying at Charlotte's now.
Yeah! I got a new place to live. I love it.
Gabe, I love it.
Good.
Yeah!
I mean it. I don't know what to say.
You can say thank you. Or maybe you're the best. Or I'm definitely naming my first and third born children Gabriel or Gabriella.
Sure thing.
Hey gang, welcome to the stream.
Didn't we already do the whole staring at me thing?
It's just, you look a lot like how I imagine you'd be.
Yeah?
Do I look how you expected?
You're still you.
You haven't really changed.
Girl,
really?
I don't know. That's your whole personality.
You still look 15.
Being awkward.
Shut up.
I mean, obviously you're like a man, dude. But she's still the same facial expressions and stuff. You're still you.
Thanks.
Which is good, because if you weren't still you...
That's your twin brother.
You have to give your gift to someone else.
Wait, what?
Surprise.
Wait, is this... this is the album I requested.
I know. I'm good.
I was going to get this for you.
Well, I got it for you first. So
I think I just said that's her brother. Okay, now this part is really awkward. Because there's no music. So it's like, I don't know how long this is, but... yeah. Yeah, she's just awkward and nerdy.
God, I can't get over this. Feels just like old times.
Oh no. Stop.
I can't. It's too late.
It's because I turned off the licensed music for copyright reasons. And now it's like really awkward. So all you hear is like
their feet shuffling. What even is that? You're way off tempo.
You just gotta let the beat flow through you.
Yeah. This is so funny because there's no music. So it's just awkward dancing for like minutes. All right, here's how it's done. Help! Help, this is so funny.
You haven't lost a beat.
Okay, that's enough.
Give me a sec.
Yeah.
Hey, Mac.
That's the one bitch's boyfriend.
Can I help you?
Something's wrong.
I read Riley's phone. I know you've been meeting with her behind my back.
Oh my god.
What do you think, Mac?
Isn't that girl like 18? He's like a grown-ass man.
My girlfriend.
Dude, oh
I promise
god.
You've got it all wrong. Tell me why I shouldn't kick your ass right now.
No. No, 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 not here. No, no, not here.
Not my place, man.
You really need to talk to your girlfriend.
I'm talking to you.
Oh.
No.
Beat his ass. Beat his ass. Why don't you sleep? Beat his ass.
Stay.
Stay.
Yeah, she has, like, powers, like, emotion powers.
Fuck!
Away from her!
Away from him!
So whenever someone's mad, like, she gets, like, a rage inside of her. Which causes her to do shit like this. And I think she can also read people's thoughts.
Alex, stop!
Oh! She really beat his ass.
I didn't.
It's okay.
Bro, lost. She has emotion powers.
This is fucking psycho.
You came up in here trying to fight. And now you're mad you lost. Yourselves. He's just an insecure little
I'm
boy.
I'm so sorry.
Don't worry about it.
Why is bro mad? She literally defended him. Because bro was really on the ground losing. Like, get your ass
up. Wait, Gabe.
Alex, it's fine.
Because he's a stupid little boy.
I gotta go stop my shift.
Like, bro, why is he mad? He was really getting his ass beat, and then his sister literally just came to the rescue and beat the other guy's ass. Like, at least be thankful.
I I'm okay.
Yeah, she ate.
I'm okay. I'm okay.
Why is bro crying?
I guess I might as well unpack.
Hey Alex, this is Ryan. It was really nice meeting you at the record store. Looking forward to talking more later. Nice meeting you too. Sounds good. How are these bitches getting my number? Cause Gabe just left. Open.
Oh God, Shushu's gonna look so grungy on this nice bed. She's gotten me through some hard times, but I was hoping we were done with that. Ethan's really talented.
Yeah, I don't care. Okay, so basically, whenever someone is feeling emotions, like really powerful emotions, she, like, her powers activate, I guess, and she can sense, like, an aura around them. So whenever someone's mad, she sees red around the person, and then she becomes, like, angry and wants to beat people up. And I think she can also read their thoughts, like, whenever they're sad. She can be like, she can, like, read their thoughts whenever they're sad or mad.
I never heard back from Sydney. I hope she's okay.
Okay, I don't care.
Alex. Do I want to know? Guess I kind of gave Gabe the runner. Anita and Eduardo. Wow. Gabe's been looking for me for a while.
Okay. Hey! I think this letter has like... Okay, like this letter is feeling angry. And so she can like... feel the anger.
Bri, I'm telling you, his story doesn't add up. He wants you.
He's helping me get into college, baby. You know dudes can do nice things without the expectation of getting laid, right?
A high school dropout? A guy who went to fucking juvie? Wants to be your study buddy? What, out of the goodness of his heart?
Oh my God, Mac, we're friends. There is nothing going on between Gabe and me.
Gabe went to juvie for what?
Crazy. Damn. How much we've changed.
Hello?
No way. Guess Gabe didn't cut out our parents. How mature. Look at them. Mom's healthy. Dad's only kind of an asshole.
I think she's bi. Because she has, like, a girl and a guy love interest in this game. So basically, her and her brother grew up in a foster care, and now they're meeting again after 8 years. And yeah, that's the whole game.
My journal.
So far.
Time to add my latest meltdown.
So Mac was reading Riley's text. Boyfriend of the year.
Bro is so insecure. She's a hoe. Hep. But for real, she wants to get with everybody. I think they're like 23. I think. Not sure though.
Ugh. I'll finish this later.
The boyfriend of the girl, the guy who came in beating everybody up because he was literally reading his girlfriend's text messages and was accusing of this grown-ass man being with his 18-year-old girlfriend. Like, boy, grow up.
No fucking way.
Like, not everybody wants your girl. Hey guys, we have more music. I feel like all of the Life is Strange games are like music based in some type of way.
Well, Alex, you just went nuts and beat the shit out of somebody in front of your brother. So,
but
how are you feeling right now?
This is her version, so I don't know. She's gonna sing this herself. Oh my god, yeah, there is no music again. But just imagine, I actually know this one. Imagine that one song that was in the Book of Life. Creep by Radiohead. Okay, can I leave? Can I leave? Because this is literally so awkward. This is so awkward because there's no music. Okay, she's singing that one song that goes like, I'm a creep, I'm a weirdo. It's creep. Yeah, the silence is so, it's so funny. Hev, what a loser. Yeah, it's so like, I can't have the music on because of the copyright, but it's like so awkward because there's like, it's just silence. They didn't even like replace it with anything. It's just like plain silence. Okay, can I leave now because it's so awkward. Oh my god, yeah, I did eat the spicy noodles. And they were so delicious. I didn't put the whole packet in it, and it was literally still spicy. But they were delicious. I ate them when I got home.
You and your damn surprises, Gabe.
Yeah, yeah. Whoa, whoa. Yup. 8.
Being here is too good to be true. I'm not gonna let anything mess it up.
No, she was in your room. And she was in her room, and when I already brought down the ramen to my room.
I should go downstairs and set things right with Gabe.
My mom was like, let me see the ramen you made. And I was like, girl, it's already in my room. Because I went upstairs to look for Coke.
I know a kicked the drywall crack when I see one.
But my dad saw me making them. And I was like, doing what you told me to.
Left in McGill County about 6 months after his arrival.
Yeah, is there like a forwarding address on file?
I'm sorry, sir. That's not information we retain. Thanks again for calling the San Miguel County Clerk's Office. Have a pleasant afternoon.
No. Hey, don't.
Okay, but my dad saw me making them, and I was like doing what you told me to do, like keep watch over them. So I had like the fork and like taking care of the noodles. And then my dad was like, OMG, do you have to like take care of the noodles or what? And I was like, yeah, I literally do.
Brian, just forget it.
Stop that. You need to take care of yourself.
Got Mac patched up. Let's take a look at you now. Oh, looks pretty nasty right about here. So, it hurts when you breathe?
Alex, you made it. Charlotte, right? Put some ice on it. I'm sorry you had to see that fight. What a terrible first impression.
Dad, I'm taking Gabe to the station. We need a first aid kit that doesn't predate the discovery of bacteria.
It's fine. I don't need to go.
Orion knows what he's doing. Now you just go with him.
Alex, I'll be back soon, okay?
Okay.
Well, there goes my bartender and my backup bartender.
My mom doesn't like ramen. She literally calls Maruchan nasty. Like, girl, what do you mean nasty?
I love that.
She just asked if it was spicy.
The falling
I was like,
star?
Yeah.
Yeah. Or rising. Depends on the day, I guess. So, what's it doing today?
Rising.
Rising. For sure. First day of my new
but
life.
My dad, oh, probably.
I'm glad Max's stupidity didn't ruin everything.
I'll let him try. I'm gonna put the whole family on these noodles.
I heard Ethan gave you an issue of his comic.
I'm gonna ask Danny if he wants to try it too.
He obviously thinks you're really cool.
Cooler than Gabe. He's a great kid.
I know literally nothing about kids, but he seems like one of the good ones. I appreciate that. He's my favorite person.
When I was gonna eat my noodles, my mom was like,
by the way, thanks for telling us about the mine.
Let me see those nasty ass noodles you made.
Yeah,
girl.
No problem. I hope you
delicious
won't be mad at me.
Ass noodles you made.
Did the right thing.
Beef pie special. Watch the gravy.
Jed, you didn't have to.
Now, Ryan said you're skipping dinner. No starving artists on my watch.
I do have to get going. I'm making some pieces for the Spring Festival, and they have to be done tonight. Sorry I couldn't talk longer. Oh, that's okay. So glad you're here, Alex. I'm looking forward to getting to know you. Yeah, same. Bye, thanks for supper.
Yep.
Oh, what a loser. Bro got his ass beat. And today my mom asked me about the noodles too. She was
so
like,
I'm short staffed at the moment.
She was like, did you go to a mercado
it
for like groceries or what?
A restaurant
and I was
before.
Like, I want to go buy those delicious
couple
ass noodles.
As a server?
Go with Gabe's story.
Maybe not as long as that. But yeah, I've done lots of things.
You want to work a shift? See if you might like it here?
Yeah.
Sure.
All right. So, we have a few folks that need checking on. Ducky and Diane over there. Steph over here.
Yo, Steph.
There's a table in the back that needs clearing also. You can give the food orders to me, and I'll handle anyone here at the bar. All right?
All right.
Got it.
Yeah, I left.
Really nice to have you here, Alex.
Thanks.
I left the bag on the kitchen counter because
I
didn't want to, like,
now.
Just put them in my room.
Let's see how this goes.
And I noticed that the bag was like open, so like I noticed that my mom was like looking to see what was inside it. And I was like, yup. And then literally today my mom asked me about it and I was like, yeah, I did. Go to El Mercado.
Can I get you two anything?
Miss Chan, here at last to relieve our suspense.
Hi.
I am Reginald McAllister III, Ducky to friends, former entrepreneur, now retired. And this young woman is Diane.
Hey there. Nice to meet you. I didn't realize that...
That we all knew you were coming. Yes. Gabe is generous with both friendship and information.
You're from Portland, right? I moved here from DC 6 months ago. How are you finding the small town thing?
Kind of perfect.
I didn't really know what to expect, but it's kind of perfect. It feels like a home.
I know. I really thought I would hate it. Then I saw the mountains, met some people, and now I'm never leaving.
Diane is a geologist, recently working as a process manager for Typhon Mining.
I'm glad there's another newbie around here, too.
Can I get you anything?
Oh, yeah, we're super hungry. I'd love a pie special with fries.
Cheeseburger with mushrooms, and my usual to drink. Jed will know what to do.
All right, I'll go put that order in. Thanks.
Wait, what? It's Haven Ships, I forgot. Haven Springs, I think. I literally forgot what they wanted. Hold on. Why is he mad? Why is bro mad?
Damn boys, always fighting. Time to grow up.
Should have seen Gabe go at it with Dad. He's come a long way. Hey, Dad.
I literally forgot what they wanted.
I've got an order from Ducky and Diane.
Go ahead.
Cheeseburger. Oh, I forgot what they wanted. What do they want? I literally forgot. It was a cheeseburger with mushrooms.
One cheeseburger with mushrooms.
Uh-huh. And?
And a pie special with fries.
One pie special with fries.
Yes, I got it.
Ducky asked for his usual?
Yep.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, he's fond of a particular rye whiskey.
I literally forgot in like 2 seconds.
Bottle for him. Oh, that's odd. I don't see it. Oh, now wait. I bet Ducky took that bottle upstairs last night. Yeah, he and Gabe went on carousing long after closing.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Serves him right if you ask me, but feel free to go upstairs and look for it. I'm sure he'd be grateful.
Hey, let me finish looking
here. If you can't find it, Deputy Pike was with him. Might have some idea. He's usually in here around now. Probably arriving soon.
There must be something around the Black Lantern that can help me find Ducky's prized whiskey.
Haven is nice. Just wish it felt like home.
Hope we both get there soon.
Typhon's not a bad company once you get used to how they operate.
Right. Starting over from scratch like this?
People keep telling me.
Fucking terrifying is what it is.
You're telling me.
Now there's this gay ass bitch.
Alex, right? I'm Steph.
Hey. Just seeing if you need food or anything.
Oh no, I'm good. Thanks though. Sorry I couldn't hang out at the record store.
Help, yeah.
I've got some time now though.
Bro's lying. Okay, let's speak. Where are you sitting with?
So are you here with somebody? Or
that's Ryan's stuff. Apparently he ditched me for Gabe.
They went to get first aid.
That's the girl again. Who Ryan's had a crush on that. Rachel
it's
in
a Lupin
the
family thing.
First game.
Have you heard about Jed's rescue? It
yeah,
was a
ship
big deal. Back when he was a minor, he saved.
I can't imagine Alex wants an earload of Haven trivia just now.
Sorry, Jed. He doesn't like to brag.
Yeah.
But there's stuff about it all over the place if you look.
Interesting.
Is that your shot?
Is that your shot? What is that?
This is bedazzled kiwi schnapps. No one's ever ordered it, so Gabe's trying to get rid of it with the jukebox game.
What's a jukebox game?
It's like a short version of 20 Questions.
I don't even know.
Where you're trying to guess a song. Guess wrong.
He got mad because his bitch is talking to me.
Take a shot.
About the town.
Ryan and I were going to play. You want to take his place?
You're on.
Dude, you're on.
Yes. So, I'll pick a song. You have 5 yes or no questions before you have to guess it.
Okay.
Let's see if I remember which one it is.
Jukebox is all yours.
I don't think I do.
So, what do you want to ask me?
I should flip through these and see what might be good to ask.
One word.
Is the band name only one word?
It is more than one word.
Symbol.
Does the band name have a symbol in it? Like something that's not just a letter?
Oh. Yeah, it totally does.
Nice. Does the band name have a person's name in it?
Nope.
Okay.
You've got 2 questions left.
Oh, I think it's this one.
Is there any punctuation in the song title?
Nope.
Okay.
Last question.
Yeah, all right, I know. Why do you like this song?
So, I guess we're breaking the yes or no questions only rule.
Can you handle it?
So, why do I like this song? The lyrics crack me up. Even the title's pretty goofy. Reminds me of fun times, I guess.
Goofy title, you say?
That's your 5. Ready to guess?
Yeah. Let me look through one last time. Here's what I know. The band name doesn't have a person's name in it. The band name does have a symbol in it.
Okay, I know. Hold on. Enter.
Okay. Fuck. Nice one.
Yeah! I got it right.
Guess I'm drinking?
Yeah!
Oh! Hey, thanks for playing. I'm really glad we did.
Me too.
What are you working on?
Is that record store inventory?
No, it's character stats. Do you know what a LARP is?
Of course I do!
Sure. Live action roleplay, right? Fantasy fighting in real life?
Yep.
Gabe was talking about a LARP with Ethan.
Yeah, it's next week. They're coming with me. It's their first time. I'm so excited. Would you ever want to join us sometime?
I'd give it a try.
Sure, I'd try it. If you and Gabe both like it, it must be super fun.
Awesome.
I should get back to work.
Okay.
There must be something around the Black Lantern that can help me find Ducky's prized whiskey.
Sure, I know. I'm just venting.
Starting over from scratch like this?
Really, I like my
fucking
job.
Fucking terrifying is what it is.
And the Oscar goes too.
Ducky, Jed thinks you took your whiskey up to Gabe's yesterday. Do you know where you might have left it?
I remember absolutely nothing of the night.
Really?
Maybe check your phone. Did you take any pictures, call anyone?
Have a look.
For goodness sake. How do I access the nice?
Yep.
Poor Ducky.
It has not been easy.
Be reading this.
Being her daughter, you can simply not say you are lonely. It has been. I don't think the kids are doing well. I shouldn't push them away from the counselor.
Sorry, nothing useful.
Well, thanks for letting me know.
Because I'm trying to find some whiskey, and he was like, okay, gang, I'll help you.
Nathan is nice.
Okay, I literally already read that.
Wish it felt like home.
Okay, I think I literally know where it's at, but let me just see everybody else first. I think it's in between like the couch or something.
I've been waiting for this all year.
I have a few favorites we can start with, and then we'll go from there.
Shit. Now Mac's scared.
Bro's scared of me.
At least he's not freaking out anymore. He won't make me lose control.
Idiot. You're gonna lose her. You're gonna lose her, and it's all your fault.
At least he's right about something.
Okay, let's go upstairs.
It's getting better for sure.
All right, yeah, I think let's see if I can find Ducky's whiskey up here.
I know where it's at. Him and his girlfriend. Y'all found it.
Found this upstairs. In Gabe's couch?
What a relief. Many thanks, Alex.
My pleasure.
My pleasure, Ducky. Can I pour you a glass?
No. No, allow me. To Miss Alex Chen, a most tenacious detective.
To Alex. Cheers.
Okay, what do I do next? Clear the table in the back.
My dad was in the service.
What table? This one?
Holy shit.
Can I talk to you real quick?
What do you want?
What do you want?
What do you want, buddy?
What happened upstairs was fucked up, right? From both of us.
What's your point?
Where are you going with this?
Look, Riley's headed over here. She's pretty heated. I don't think it helps to recap all the gory details, you know?
You want me to lie?
So you're saying you want me to lie to cover your ass?
No. No, just, like, let me handle it.
Look, she's gonna break up with me otherwise.
Yeah, because you're literally an asshole.
We've been together 4 years. She is the best thing that's ever happened to me. So please, help me out.
I don't know about that, buddy.
I don't know, man.
Shit.
What the fuck is wrong with you? Oh my god. Look at your face.
No, it's okay.
Don't even. What were you thinking? Where's Gabe?
Why do you give a shit?
Because my boyfriend just got into a fight with him. I swear. This is it. You better have a good explanation or... we're done.
It's not my fault. I just wanted to talk to the guy.
You literally came in here throwing hands.
About why you guys are meeting behind my back.
Oh my gosh, shut up.
Okay.
Nobody cares.
So how did the fight happen?
He needs to get over it.
The bastard sucker punched me.
Nah. I'm gonna defend my brother.
Not exactly sucker punched, but he definitely started
it. No, he didn't. He was really laying on the ground.
Oh, God. Are you
there
too? I'm
gonna defend my brother. Yeah, I was the one who beat his ass. Nah, buddy. I'm gonna defend my brother.
Yeah, I was there. Max telling you a whole lot of bullshit. You know what? That doesn't even surprise me anymore. So what really happened?
Riley.
Mac barged in, accused Gabe of sleeping with you, sucker punched him, and then kicked him while he was down.
Riley, listen.
What happened to Mac's face?
That was me.
I did that. Well, good. It sounds like he deserved it. Thanks for telling me the truth, Alex.
Wait, are we okay?
Are you fucking serious? I'm so embarrassed by you right now.
But are we still together?
Bitch. What do you think, you fucking idiot? No.
Why would she still be together with you after that?
Assaulting Matt Loudon on your first day here, huh?
Ugh.
I'm Jason Pike, the deputy sheriff. I'm gonna have to take you in for questioning.
I think he was assaulting us first. What about Mac?
Mac assaulted Gabe. He's the one you want.
Your face.
Oh, I thought he was serious.
You should see your face.
After the last game, I thought he was serious.
No, I'm only kidding. Nobody's in trouble here. Gabe and I just like to prank each other.
I've never been pranked by a cop before. You definitely got me.
Thanks for being a good sport. Can I buy you a drink?
Maybe. I'm working right now.
Well, I'll be at the bar. You want one, you just come by, okay?
Okay, what's my objective? Let Jed know the tasks are done.
Christ, she did that to that guy's face?
Yeah.
Steering clear.
Aw, I'm already making friends.
Oh, good. Are you finished up with everything you want to do?
Yes.
Yeah, I took care of everything you mentioned. Is there anything else you'd like me to do?
Nah, the boys should be back soon. Well, speak of the devil. How you feeling?
Not great. Not awful.
I got Alex covering for you.
For real? We need to talk. I'll be on the rooftop, okay?
Okay.
I think that's enough for today. You did great work. You'll be a damn fine addition to our team. You can't keep an injured man waiting.
I ate.
You better go upstairs.
Thanks.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, let's just go.
Time to talk to Gabe.
Wait, is the stream lagging? I think it's lag or buffer. Hold on.
How's your jaw?
Not this again, buddies.
Is the pain bad? Look, Gabe, I'm really sorry.
Okay, never mind. It is. I had to log in. Okay, now it's okay. Because it showed red on my OBS, but once I logged into my Twitch, it said it was excellent, so. I'll just keep the Twitch screen on just in case. Yeah, hopefully it's good now. Did you rehearse that move?
Did you rehearse that move?
Yeah, because no. It was showing red on my screen.
Only in my
but
mind.
But once I logged into Twitch, it said the stream
need
was
a manager
excellent.
For your underground cage
green.
Fighting career?
It's in the green right now. Hopefully, it'll stay
really
in the green.
Sorry.
How many bones have you broken? Like, on other people?
Dude, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you.
Don't apologize. I'm fine. Now that we're talking about it, guess I never realized.
Think I'm a crazy person?
That I'm a crazy person?
No, come on. I never realized what your life must have been like. On your own.
It was fine.
You know, when I pulled you off the Mac, and you hit me, I was angry. Then I thought about how you took him apart. Like you've done it before.
Yeah, because I did. I fought a lot.
Kids in foster care fight a lot. I learned how to defend myself.
I'd say. I can tell there's something going on with you. Something troubling you. Maybe it's time you open up.
I want to talk to Gabe. What can I even say right now to explain what happened with Mac?
I'm going to tell him about my power. Wait, no, I clicked the wrong one. Oh, well, whatever.
Growing up in the system was hell. In my first foster home, an older boy followed me into the bathroom. So I pushed him out. He got angry. So did I. Then I broke his nose. I was 14. In the second home, one of the other kids committed suicide. And I couldn't eat for a month. After a couple of weeks in the fifth home, I got so depressed that my new parents sent me to a hospital. I never saw him again. The hurt follows me everywhere. I'd see other kids get adopted, leave the system. Not me. They never picked me. I'm broken.
Damn, what a crazy story.
Do you really believe that?
Today I do.
Today I do. Socking your own brother in the jaw is one for the record books.
I don't even feel it anymore.
That's not the point. Look at you. You've got a home, a job, a girlfriend. You've got everything figured out. And I don't.
What's that? Is that for me?
Is that for me?
It is now.
What is
Don't
this?
Give up. Wow, so inspirational.
Looks like a match to me.
That was the last matchbook I got when I was still in juvie. Did some pretty unsavory stuff to score it.
And you still have it?
Yeah. I carry it with me everywhere. When I got out, I went through the last few matches real quick, obviously, but I could never bring myself to use the last one. It reminded me how bad life got and how much better I was going to make it.
Thank you.
I don't know what to say.
You're welcome.
When I first played this game, like years ago, I literally got spoiled because of the box. The box of the game literally tells you
Haven and Charlotte,
what happened.
I couldn't believe they were real.
It's in this episode.
Everything before was such
hell. The plot of the game hasn't happened yet. Like,
yeah, it's different.
The moment, like the big moment of the game is in this episode. It's later on in the episode.
Start a new life.
Like the whole plot of the game.
You made it out of the system, Alex. You survived. It's time to move on.
Maybe you're right.
Maybe you're right. I came to Haven, after all.
Exactly. That's the first step. And don't forget, I'm here to help you.
Hey, gang! Welcome to the stream.
So, when were you going to tell me about the guitar?
Oh, shit. You found it. It was supposed to be a huge surprise.
Surprise?
Well, what do you think?
I love it.
I love it. Thank you so much.
Of course. Welcome home. Oh, hey, dude, what's up?
Hey, is Ethan up here?
No, he was heading home.
He was, but I haven't seen him in a while.
You don't think...
Maybe.
OMG!
Fuck, maybe he did.
What is it?
I think he went up to the mountains.
If he actually did, we need to move. Now.
Let's go.
This is the part of the game where it's like the part I got spoiled at.
Ethan!
MG, this little ass kid! Where's his mom? Why is his mom not here?
Alex. This way.
Wow. Been a while since I was up here.
Why don't you come here?
You don't do your ranger stuff around here?
Private land. Outside of my jurisdiction. Dad brought me up here a bunch when I was little, though. I was his minor in training. That was back before mining meant blowing the tops off mountains. Any luck?
In touch base with the safety team up at the site. They're gonna postpone tonight's blast until we find them.
Oh, at least we're not racing the clock. Hey, you good?
Charlotte's gotta be losing it right now.
Hey, she's tough. Always has been. Come on, let's take a look around.
This kid, can you imagine the shit we would have caught from Dad if we'd done anything like this?
Hey, we're gonna find him.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Hey, thanks again for your help. Could have been a lot worse if you hadn't kept me in the loop.
Of course.
I'm gonna go take a look around. Let me know if you spot any sign of Ethan.
Sure. I can do that. How was Ethan planning to get into the mine?
Can I read your thoughts or what? OMG, who's texting me?
Something tells me those two weren't the best match.
Let me read his shits.
Alex warned me. I could have stopped this. I'm such a fucking fuck-up.
Gabe cares about Ethan much. We have to find him.
Come on, Ryan. Everyone is depending on you.
Ryan won't let his fear get in the way. I'm glad he's here. What happened here?
Massive cave-in. Bunch of trapped miners. All nearly died. Jed led the whole team back to the surface.
God.
Yeah, that's the day Foreman Jed became local hero Jed. And then Typhon closed up this site, basically bought Jed the Black Lantern.
Huh. Same logo. Did Ethan base his comic on this place? Okay. If the wall is an illusion...
Okay, let's go back. I don't know what I'm supposed to do, but okay.
Nothing obvious. Maybe we should...
Notice anything?
No shit.
I'll be damned.
The whole story is about Ethan's character breaking into a monster stronghold deep underground.
Sounds like the mine to me. Does it show where he went?
Not sure. The comic ends with the monster hunter climbing a watchtower, which shows him where to go. There. The silo. I bet that's the tower. That's where he went.
You're a genius.
Yeah. Great find, Alex. Gabe, you want to take a crack at unlocking that gate?
I'm on it.
We should also be able to get to it through the processing building. If we can find a way in.
Let's take a look then. Okay.
All right, buddy,
Ethan
let's go.
He based his comic on this place. Maybe I should compare his drawings with other stuff in the area. No dice. I need to find something like that dead guy Thaynor finds.
This guy?
So if the zombie is here, then...
I don't know. And then, the trail... Hello, it's across over here. Okay.
If Ethan really followed the path in his comic, finding him just became a lot more doable.
This way? No.
I don't think the Trail of Blood led to the toxic Avenger sludge in the comic.
This way? No.
Nope. I have to follow the same trail that Thaynor did. I think Thaynor went a different way.
You're not that way. That way? This way? Okay, I guess it's this way.
Wait, so... did Ethan... oh, man. Think there's like a side door back there?
I don't know. I guess there might be.
Give me a hand.
Okay.
Okay, finally.
You figured that out from a comic book.
I'm gonna try to get the lights on. You try to figure out where Ethan went.
All right. Let's go. Hey guys.
Ethan must have come through here. How did he get out?
Troy and find this little boy.
I mean, it seems like a slim chance, but...
What?
It's a long shot, but there's a couple disconnected wires in the box. A red one and a blue one.
The red one?
Go with red!
Wait, I don't know.
It's always red. Nope. Thaynor doesn't battle any bed bugs.
This one.
I wonder how you open this thing. Is there a button around somewhere?
I'm not confident this is gonna work.
Boy, me neither. Oh.
Damn it.
My bad. My bad, buddy. Okay, where do I go? Go now. Okay, let's go upstairs. The entrance, okay.
Ethan must have gone upstairs. Pretty sure Ethan climbed these... wasn't in the comic.
Okay, let me turn around then.
Not in the comic.
Okay, let's go the other way, goddamn. Did we find it? Okay, let's go back.
Ethan made the jump from here to the conveyor belt? Oof. I think I'll find another way through. Looks like Ethan climbed the conveyor belt out. Heads up!
You figured out the door.
Yeah.
Oh, turns out you gotta open it. Who knew?
Will wonders never cease.
Anne, you okay?
I'm sorry to call you at work. I just came home from the doctor. I couldn't wait for you to come home.
Baby doll?
I'm pregnant, Jed.
Oh. Here, where are these bitches? Where do I go? Oh, this way. That's Gar.
What took you so long? You never forget how to break a lock. It's like riding a bike.
Hey, well, why didn't he let us know and just let us in?
Where to next, Alex?
Thanor looks out from the watchtower and spots the secret entrance to the stronghold. If we can just... There. That's where he's heading.
That's by the ravine.
Shit. Let's go. We close?
Think so.
Ethan!
Bro is gone. Down there,
Ethan. Alex, I'm scared.
Then why did you go there in the first place, dumb mother boy?
Ethan, I'm coming for you, buddy.
Wait, hold on. Ethan, you okay? Don't worry, we're gonna get you out of here. Just hang on.
Fear is so strong. If I get near it...
It's no good. We're too heavy.
Shit. Yeah,
I can go. I guess.
What about me?
Alex. Are you sure?
Remember how I taught you how to anchor a belay? Awesome. Show me.
You okay?
I'm okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm all right.
You sure? It's okay if you're not.
No, I'm good.
You know, I actually believe you when you say that. Alex, can you make eye contact with me?
Yeah.
I'm gonna tie this rope around your waist. The other end is tied around your brother. He'll use that stump as a fulcrum to feed rope your direction. Follow?
So far.
Awesome. You're doing super good. Remember, slow is steady. Steady's fast. Piece of cake.
Piece of cake. Hang on, Ethan. I'm coming.
All right, let's go. I think this episode's almost over.
Go back! You'll get hurt!
Not without you.
I'm not going back without you. You're stuck with me till we're both safe.
OMG, this dumbass little boy!
Doing great, sis.
Bro thought he was in a comic book.
Hey, Ethan, I'm here to help, okay?
No! Get away!
Shit. It's too much. I have to get him to chill out. Ethan, I need you to calm down. Can you breathe for me?
I should never have come out here! I was so stupid!
Okay, hey, focus. Talk to me. You wanna tell me how you got out here?
I was trying to cross to the other side. A log fell.
That's fine. That's okay. Let's talk about what comes next.
Gabe is our anchor.
Gabe's got us. We're not gonna fall. He's got the other end of the rope.
No, I can't move. If I move...
You're not gonna fall, buddy!
It doesn't matter!
Oh, come on, buddy, let's go!
He's not making any sense. I need him to calm down. We can't stay here, Ethan. We have to...
It'll see me! If I move, it'll see me!
What? What's gonna see you?
Does he have powers too, or what?
I don't understand.
He's right. I don't. I can't help him if I don't understand what he's afraid of. And the only way to understand is to feel what he's feeling. Oh, fuck. I can't believe this is happening.
I can do this. Move on, little boy.
I can do this.
She transferred his feelings over to herself, so I guess now the little boy isn't scared.
Oh my god. What's happening? It's like I'm seeing the world through his eyes.
I am Gordon. Would it be afraid? But he's just a story. This is real.
I'm not just feeling what Ethan feels. I'm seeing the world like he sees it.
I brought all this stuff. None of it will save me. Save me.
I thought I could
hurt the monster. But it's hunting me.
Yes, okay. You should make spicy noodles.
He's
while
afraid of the
watching
fall.
This stream.
He's afraid of...
Oh, shit. see me. Can't let it see me.
It can't be real. Oh, but it looks pretty fucking real. Hey. Hey, I see it too, Ethan. The monster? I see it too. And I'm just as scared as you are. But Ethan, we're safe. You know why?
That thing can't see us.
It can't see me. Bangle of vanishing, just like Ninth Warden.
I thought that was just a story.
Well, some stories are true, like monsters. So, you're gonna hold my hand, all right? As long as you're touching me, you're safe.
Is he just gonna leave all his shit there? How did that shit even go everywhere?
Don't look down, okay? We'll be done before you know it.
They're headed back. Keep tight on the belay, Gabe.
Not over yet. Oh, God. Okay. One step at a time.
Let's go. Rose, are slow.
Yeah, buddy? I'm still really scared.
Nothing to be scared of.
There's nothing to be afraid of. I got you.
But what if you let go?
I won't. Come on.
Do you think the log will break?
I've got you.
I don't know. But if it does, I am gonna hold on to you so tight, okay?
Okay.
Yes, you should all make spicy noodles. They're delicious. While watching my stream, of course. Okay, we're almost across. This episode is over in like a few minutes anyways. Oh.
They're good, man. Tight grip. We're close now.
That's it. Come on. There you go. I got you.
This is the part. This is the part. The whole plot happens here. Girl, you're not gonna be laughing. You're not gonna be laughing soon. Him to get knocked the fuck out like that. Like, bro flipped. Yeah, buddy. Buddy is not alive after that. Okay, so, yeah. Alex O'Gabe about Ethan's plans, 50%. Alex O'Reilly, the truth about the fight, 65%. Alex O'Gabe about growing up in foster care, 31%. I was gonna tell him about my power, but I clicked the wrong one. Okay. Okay, let's go to the main menu. Damn, bro just died in like 2 seconds. Oh my god. When I was first buying the game, I literally got spoiled on that part, on the fucking box. I was really so mad because I did not know anything about the game. And then literally the box was like, after the death of her brother. And then I was playing the game, I was like, he literally dies. Damn, bro. That shit took me out when he went flying with the rock. So yeah, buddy is not alive after literally rocks falling onto him. Yeah. Okay, so yeah, basically, he's dead. And yeah, that's the whole plot. Basically, the whole plot is like Alex going on about her life when her brother died. And yeah, I'll post a vote on YouTube when I get off, I think. All of my socials are linked in my bio. I hope you enjoyed this episode. It was just the first episode. I think there are 5 episodes in total. And there's also a DLC for Steph's story, which I love Steph. Steph 8. And yeah. I hope you enjoy this episode. And I did stream really early today, actually. It's literally like 8:30 and I'm like barely getting off. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this episode and I'll see you next time with another episode of Life is Strange. Bye!